What are they going to be feeling like on that boat?
They are going to be feeling excited. They'll be feeling nervous. I know what it'd be like if I was racing. The butterflies would be going, and yeah. It's going to be an incredible experience for them. I think a lot of them actually just don't know what is coming their way. It's a really big deal.
Go! Yeah. And again!
Yeah.
Three, two, one, go! I'm paid a lot of money.
Are you feeling in shape?
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
Major nerves. It's quite interesting coming across on the boat. It's quite emotional. Because it's kind of like 6 months of training for this one event.
I did the Great Lakes 3 day and it snowed on me and then rained on me and then I camped in a swamp. So I'm ready for this.
I think the stress from this will distract from every other stress in your life, which is quite nice.
I'm not daunted at all. Got to do it before I'm 75.
Are you going to race it?
5 miles.
It's 8 days. A lot can happen, so yeah, we'll see.
How's it going?
Good. Yourself?
Good.
They're going to such remote and unusual and beautiful places. So many people, they might think they know Scotland, but they don't, and this is going to blow them away.
Is this your usual Monday morning?
Yeah, this one's much better.
Day two?
Day two, feeling better than day one so far. Hoping to make it to day three.
Opening up your legs already.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't be. I should be saving it up, I think, but too tempting. I would rather be sitting at my desk in the office, but someone's got to do this, haven't they?
What do you think today's got in store?
A few challenges, a few nice hills, and plenty of rain. But lots of fun.
Finally, some real running. Now the race really begins, I think.
Are you up for racing it?
Yeah, but just be careful because it's a long way to go. Just have to go too fast from the beginning.
You're not going that slow. Good luck.
28, please, John. You alright?
Yes.
How was that?
That was incredible. I went in like five times.
Swimming
I
away.
Need a little flag so I can.
It's like being chased by a big chocolate orange.
Over here, Marcus, here. So you're taking a swim over there.
Yeah, I don't mind Wendy, that's the impression.
How's your day been?
Oh, it's been tough. I think I set off a bit too fast. But it's just, this is the day where you go, okay. So that's what it's all about. The scenery, the terrain. Yeah, it's been amazing.
I had a bit of a meltdown between 20 and 26, but sort of pulled it back a wee bit, but yeah, it's tough. But I mean, unbelievable setting again, stunning. Absolutely stunning, so Knoydart conquered.
Tough day today. It was another good day for me.
You're not the first to say it was hard.
Yeah. It's part of the racing. Hard day, long day, hard day, fast day. It's just two more days to go.
But awesome, brilliant course.
You still cranked along there.
Yeah, it went all right. A bit of a wobble about halfway, but after that I kind of got myself together. These socks were new this morning.
It just was spectacular, absolutely spectacular. And the feeling of that remoteness as well, which you don't often get in a race. Today it became a lot more technical, and this is what I'd been kind of training for. Been training a lot on bleak low and kinder, boggy, trussy, you know, where you've got to change your stride constantly, watch where you're placing your foot, but do it quickly. So once we got onto that, I was just able to keep moving at the same kind of pace and heart rate as well.
Yeah, a little bit trepidatious today, but yeah, it'll be all right. Yeah, hoping to get in for the cut-off.
I feel all right now, but I've just had breakfast and I like, so that's me in about 30 miles.
Yeah, in there, please. Well done. Have a good one.
Okay, thank you.
Well done.
Day two was really hard. It's the first time that the runners get a real sense of how rough and tough the terrain is and remote. Day three is more of the same, a bit more runnable, but it's longer.
I go back about 25 years when I was in my training to be a doctor, and I was working 120 hours a week with no days off. And one spring day, I just said, I've got to be outside and active and moving. There's something about running that is a little bit hard to describe that I just need to do. Yeah, it's like eating and sleeping, just need to do it.
I was really quite poorly about 25 years ago. I had cancer of the thyroid and just started to run. And it was something that got me through everything. Got me through my treatments. It made me so fit and strong, although to begin with people questioned what I did. Putting my running shoes on was a way of me saying I'm still here. It was empowering.
I've built a career and a family, and I've done what I set out to do. So maybe the appeal for this also is to set a challenge that you're not quite sure you're able to do. That's a pretty rare thing.
And also not thinking that things aren't possible, because unless you give it a go, who knows? So, you know, I think that, and then the camaraderie, whether you're one of the slowest ones like me or whether you're the fastest. It's just great, love it.
Oh, it's been so good. What a wonderful day. Amazing, huh?
Oh. Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah. It's been perfect.
Looking forward to chips now. Apparently, if there's any left. Yeah. It was amazing. The last bit was great. Yeah, didn't think it was going to end today. But no, it was great.
This is my fourth year running. Yeah. Not a long time. I had this dream to run the New York Marathon before I was 50, and I entered the lottery and I won the lottery, so I thought, oh, I have to start running seriously now. So I started training, and with the training I started feeling better and fitter. But then I discovered trail. I didn't even know it existed.
It's wonderful. I was hoping to see some eagles, but I haven't seen any. But it's beautiful. Amazing.
And since then I've just been wanting to travel, and trail really brings you into the nature. That's what really I love about it. My English grandmother always used to tell me we have some Scottish ancestors, so coming to Scotland and live the ground where my ancestors were here, you know, it's been quite an experience. I'm loving it.
Glad to be a runner today.
Yeah, it's good. We are feeling good.
She's feeling good.
Yeah, you are a bit.
I'm a bit nauseous, but it's okay.
It's okay. And of course, we love your mountains.
Yes.
But we won't tell anybody in Holland.
It's our secret.
We won't do that.
I think the first time I came up to the Highlands was when I was 7 years old, I think. Just love the Highlands of Scotland. So for me, it's the best bits of the race just feel like a holiday, you know. So I just enjoy it for its own sake. Brilliant to be out in the middle of nowhere, getting to places that you wouldn't otherwise get to. There's a challenge element to it as well. So that's kind of you against the course, and then where you end up in the field is an outcome of that. So it's less about speed and more about how you deal with it upstairs, cranking along when everything hurts and everything tells you that you shouldn't. Not too bad today, actually. Bit of a recovery day, really. It's fairly steady.
Yes, every day Marcus Scottney has been charging through the course. He's kind of every day building, you know, another 5-10 minutes on the other runners. But Thomas is just behind him, not far away. Pavel's behind him. So there's all to play for, and 5-10 minutes, even 30 minutes is nothing over 8 days. And you know, one navigation error, one sprained ankle. So they're very close. They're very close.
Kind of a bit more racing today. I knew of it being shorter, but I really wanted to kind of race it, push it a little bit, and see what Tom would do, if he could react to it. And I saved enough from yesterday, so I knew that on the climbs I could still work it. And it was a rough section where I knew it was going to test a lot of people.
When you're running with someone, you can tell pretty quickly relative speed, you know, how hard they're working, how hard you're working. Yeah, I mean, I think he's faster than I am, he's technically better than I am. I think it'd be a mistake to go chasing him around the course. Yeah, it just looks so easy. Makes you feel very lumbering in comparison.
What I liked a lot about this race is that we are made responsible for ourselves. You have the map, you know you have to get where you have to get, but everything hurts. But the hurting is healing in a way. It clears you out of all the toxins, all the bad thoughts. I'm much better when I go home. It's simple life, and that's what we need every now and then, I think.
How's it going with the eagle eye?
Oh, it's fabulous, we're loving it. Amazing, it's tough, it's hard work, but it's so spectacular.
I find it very emotional because there's so many things tied up in it. I've wanted to do it for such a long time. There's that slight, you know, are you taking on something that's bigger than you are? And I've just found it incredible. The landscapes are beautiful. Everybody is super. They all support you. And the journey has been 100% bigger. In every way, if I'm honest, but 100% grander as well.
Had a little bit of problems yesterday with our chins, I guess, ankles, but we're all right now, I think. Maybe we'll manage this, at least walking, who knows.
We thought we'd see the worst blisters, the worst macerated feet, but it's been more the rigours of the trail, the nature of the ground turning their lower limbs, ankles, hips, knees, backs, and it's that's causing them to hang back and wonder overnight whether to restart, and then you can see them going, yeah, I'm okay, I can start today. Quite tough. The participants that have found this event and have started, their minds are pretty much ready, and it means that their minds have pushed their bodies a bit harder, and will the body keep functioning?
How's you doing, bud?
Cool.
You're in a lot of pain.
Yeah.
Anything we can do?
Another leg.
Yeah.
No. What? Gutted. Not good. I'm afraid I'm out of the competition.
You're doing quite well as well, weren't you?
Yeah.
Happened?
I think it's just a combination of just a strain injury, ankles blown up, rough ground, don't know, a world of pain today, gutted, devastated to be honest with you. 6 days in, 2 to go, and that's it, all over.
Yes, well done.
Well done, Diva.
Thank you. Oh, I have done something to this leg. They taped it up. I don't know what's wrong with it. It's purple and it's hurting really badly, so.
Tough day.
Slow day. I now know how it feels to walk 72 kilometers. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
painful and questionable, but you know what? Coming down that mountain, you know, with the sun setting, and it's the most beautiful thing you'll ever see in your life. So maybe I can do it again tomorrow. We'll see.
People are emotional, but people seem pretty focused generally, actually. Everyone knows that they've done the biggest day now. They still have another big day, then they're almost there. And I'd say the atmosphere is determined and stoic. And I'm greatly impressed by the participants. They have totally exceeded my expectations. I didn't think we would have as many still in the race. It's amazing. Totally impressed. We're in uncharted territory. That there's just no other races in the UK like this, really. Yes, it is very different. It's hard on participants, it's hard on the team. You can just see there's a lot of people who are teetering on the edge. So yeah, there are people on the finishing line, and you can see the tears in their eyes, and you know if you were to give them a hug, the floodgates would open.
That's the most difficult stage we've done, I think.
Jelly cooler.
Widen your grip.
Yeah, remember there's quite a lot of people to come through after you.
Fuck them. Oh, sorry.
Do you want to choke on your polo ball?
How are you feeling, Mr. Rawlinson?
I'm about to transition from involved to very bored. I'm about to enter into 4 hours utterly pointless minor discomfort that will bring no good into the world whatsoever.
You're doing well.
I'm not tired.
You're not? You're not tired?
Absolutely not. I look like, but...
Where are you from?
Belgium. Jolly Brussels.
Good. You're doing well.
It's flat.
You're doing very well.
Thank you.
What a hard day today.
Oh yeah. They're building, aren't they?
It's the hardest day of them all. I thought I was going to stay up there. It's very hard. We're almost there though.
Have you had doubts today?
Yeah, many. I couldn't eat, I felt sick. I wanted to stay there. I sat down and I said enough. Sorry, I can't speak, I'm not well.
Yeah, it's all right.
Sorry. I do it for my children. I do it because Ethel is there waiting for me. If it was for me, I'd stop. Basta.
Watch out, there's a car.
Been psychologically tough as you thought, all that preparation.
I think it's harder when you reach your limits.
Push on.
And you crack a bit. But there's wonderful people. And it's been a team effort. Our tent has been amazing. People have run together, people have supported each other. So it's tough, but
oh look! Oh come on.
Alright, see you.
Well done, Ali!
Oh, well done.